வெல்கம் டு இபிஜி பாடசாலா. ஐ எம் ப்ரொஃபஸர் ராஜவேலு, மேரிடைம் ஹிஸ்ட்ரி அண்ட் மெரின் ஆர்கியாலஜி, தமிழ் யூனிவர்சிட்டி, தஞ்சாவூர். த பேப்பர் இஸ் இந்தியன் எபிகிராஃபி, த மாடல் இஸ் உத்தரமேரு இன்ஸ்கிரிப்ஷன். டுடே வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி அண்ட் இன்ட்ரெஸ்டிங் இன்ஸ்கிரிப்ஷன்ஸ் ரிகார்டிங் தி எலெக்ஷன் சிஸ்டம் ஆஃப் இந்தியா இன் ஏன்ஷியன்ட் இந்தியா அரவுண்ட் 1000 AC. திஸ் இன்ஸ்கிரிப்ஷன் வி ஹவ் ஃபவுண்ட் ஆன் த வால்ஸ் ஆஃப் எ டெம்பிள் a village known as Uttaramerur in Tamil Nadu. Generally, we have come across the democracy system in the world, in the present context. In the modern world, democracy, republic are the words very often we are using that. But in India, the democracy system we have come across around 1000 AD itself. There is an inscription at Uttaramerur referring to this system of a village body known as Variya Perumakkal, the Sabha. In this paper, we are going to know the local self-government of ancient Tamil Nadu, to know the procedure of election system of ancient Tamil Nadu, to understand the qualifications of the members of local body and significance of the village administration system. Democracy, the meaning is the rule of people. In modern usage, it is very often used by all people, which means the citizens exercise their power directly or elect their representatives to form the government. Uttaramerur is an ancient village in Uttaramerur Taluk in Kanjipuram district of Tamil Nadu. It is a unique village in the days of Pallavas and Cholas of medieval period and later on. When it was existed, we don't know, because we have the earliest inscriptions here is the Pallava. But the name Uttaramerur reflects it was created by Pallava king. Uttara means north. The Meru is a mountain. Generally, Uttaramerur is a Chaturvedi Mangalam. Generally, in Tamil Nadu, all the Chaturvedi Mangalam either named after the king's name or queen's name. It is attached with the royal titles. But in Uttaramerur, we don't have such kind of king's names or queen's names in this. The Uttara referring to the north and Meru is a mountain. It witnessed the rule of people on their own to administrate the village through an election system. This is the earliest evidence of election system in India that is ruled over by people so far found in the world around 10th century CE. The antiquity of the Uttaramerur introduction. The antiquity of the village goes back to Iron Age. We have a megalithic tomb very near to the paddy field in the village on the northwestern part of the village. It shows the antiquity of the village dates back to 3000 BP. In the inscription of Pallavas, the village was referred to as Uttaramerur Chaturvedi Mangalam, a settlement occupied by the learned Brahmins well versed in four Vedas. Generally, the Chaturvedi Mangalam referring to the people who occupied with well-versed in four Vedas. That is, Chadur means four. Mangalam denotes a auspicious village. The name of the village suggested that the village was flourished during the time of Pallavas around 6th or 7th century CE. There are nearly 100 inscriptions so far discovered in this village. We have quite a number of temples in and around. The village itself founded with Vastu Sastra. Vastu Purusha. An interesting inscription says it was created by a man who well versed in Vastu. So, all the cardinal points of the village invariably occupied by Digbalas and other village deities like Durga, Saptamatrika, etc. and village goddess and gods are occupied all the cardinal points. Other Brahminical temple also occupied in the center of the village. The village has many Shiva and Vishnu temples. Nearly 100 inscriptions have been reported in this village, mostly found on the walls of the temples of the village. On the western side of the village, there is an irrigation tank, which is a major water source for the agricultural lands of the area, referred to as Vairamega Tadaga in the inscription. It is a large tadaga, that is a large irrigation tank, irrigated nearly all the fertile lands of the village. On the platform of the Vaigunda Perumal, there is a temple known as Vaigunda Perumal Temple. Now it is occupied near the bus stand, once it was a place surrounded by, assembled by the people, local people. Now it is converted to a bus stand. In the bus stand area, there is a temple known as Vaikuntha Perumpaal Temple, which has a small garbhagriha. In front of that, we have a huge mandapa with a roof. Here, people will assemble and make resolution for the village affairs. This mandapa is having a platform on the rear portion of the mandapa. On the western side, we have two interesting inscriptions regarding the election system of ancient village administration. This is a Vaikuntha Perumal temple with a small garbhagriha. On the rear, we have a small garbhagriha. In front, we have the big mandapa to people assemble. And on the side of the garbhagriha also, we have the roofed mandapa to sit people and discussion about the election system or the village administration. Generally in Tamil Nadu, the Chaturvedi Mangalam was created by the kings, which are named after the kings or queens' names. But the Uttarameru does not have this component to know the foundation of the village. However, the term Meru is generally adorned by the Bana chiefs. The later Chola period, it had the name Uttarameru. We have many temples, as already pointed out in this temple. The important temples are Vaikuntha Perumal Temple, Sundaravarada Raja Perumal Temple, Subramaniya Temple, Kailasanatha Temple, Kolambeswara Temple, Madhuri Amman Temple, and Rettaithal Ishwara Temple in this village. These are the major temples in the village. And also, we have many local deities temples also. Every year, they are celebrating festivals and pujas in these temples. An inscription of Sanskrit language at Sundaravarada Perumal Temple in the same village refers to the interesting information regarding the building of the temple with the Nams Vastu Sastra, which I have mentioned already. He is the architect of the village and architect of the entire temple architecture of the village. Many South Indian villages had their own autonomous to rule and fulfill their affairs. They were known as Sabha or Ur. In South India, particularly in Tamil Nadu, most of the inscriptions we are having the village administrative system. It says, if it is a Brahminical village, it says it was ruled over by a member of Brahmin community consisting of Sabha. It is known as Sabha. If it is a agricultural based people living in the village, it was ruled over by a Urar. And they were controlled over by the Natar. So this is the system of ancient Tamil Nadu. And at the most, all these components were controlled by the central government, which is headed by a king. The Sabha, the local administrative body, is consisting of Brahmins, and Urar assembly was occupied by the agriculture people and other village communities. Uttarameru was administrated by the Brahmin members. As I have mentioned already, it is a Chaturvedi Mangalam, so Brahmin community dominated in this village. Even other people also lived in this village. The Vaikuntha Perumal Temple bears many interesting inscriptions, and the earliest inscription is dated to Dandivarman rule. This is the earliest inscription. Dandivarman was a Pallava king. During the time of Dandivarman also, we had a Sabha like this. It is known as Perunguri Sabha. The village was self-sufficient and independent one, ruled over by the elected body known as Sabha or Perunguri Sabha. The village was divided into 12 series. The village is comparisingly very large in portions. It has divided into 12 series. These series were named after the names of God, Vishnu, and further divided into 30 kutams, that is wards. Nowadays, the wards are using in the election system. It was already used in Tamil inscription as Kudumbus. Each ward Kudumbus ward have a number of families, and they had equal share and the lands in the village. This is the inscription referring to the election system and procedure, how to conduct the election and the qualification, disqualifications of the candidates. This is the this inscription issued by a Parandaga Chola. First, he ruled from 907 to 953-55 ACE. So during his time, in his regnal year 2019, he issued a inscription. It issued one inscription, interesting inscription. it refers the election system. And again, after 2 years also, in 921 AD, he issued another inscription. It is also referring to the election system. Some modification, we can see some modification in these second inscriptions. The first inscription says, it starts with Mangala Sulaga Sasistri and the king name Parandaga Chola. In his 14th regnal year, he sent a central government person as an election officer, and they conduct a election with the help of the eldest people and the priests of the village. This inscription is very much interesting. It says the Kudavalai, it is in Tamil, the part ticketing system. The part ticketing system in Tamil, it is referred to in the inscription as Kudavalai Murai. So the Kudavalai Murai, how they conduct, what are the qualifications, what are the disqualifications, how they function, what are the period, it is all mentioned in this English inscription. It is referred to in the 19th regnal year of the king, that is 919, that is 12th regnal year, 919 CE. This is the portion of this is a biggest inscription. This is a long inscription, so it mentions everything, all these aspects. The village assemblies were able administrative body of the village. They were generally referred to as Oor or Sabha, as already I have mentioned. The Brahminical settlement administered by Sabha or Perunguri Sabha. In most of the inscription, it is mentioned at Sabha. In some of the village, we have Perunguri Sabha. Many Brahminical settlements in Tamil country during early part of Chola region witnessed this kind of local administrative system. We are having quite a number of villages, this kind of system. But this inscription is very particular. It mentions elaborately. We have many inscriptions. We have earlier inscriptions in Tirunelveli. There is a place known as Manur. This is a Pandya inscription. It referring to the election system in Tamil Nadu, in the southernmost part of Tamil country. The members of the committee in the Brahminical settlements were elected. Two inscriptions of Uttaramerur, as I mentioned earlier, refer to the election system and qualifications prescribed in very detailed manner. In the 12th regnal year of Parandaga Chola, that is 919 CE, it was issued an order, that is a royal order, which was engraved on the western side of the pedestal of the temple at Vaigunda Perumal temple. It focused some attention on the election system for local self-government. On the western side of the same wall, there is another inscription issued by the same king Parandaga I in his 14th regnal year, that is 921 CE. It has some modifications. He found some difficulties in the early system of regulations. So he changed some of the qualification, the age and other things in the second inscription. So he practiced in the early already, and he got some experience. Then he changed some modifications in this inscription. In the second inscription, some modifications we have done, we are having that. In the 12th regnal year of Parandaga Chola, that is 919 CE, it was issued under the guidance of the king, which was endured on the western side, as already I mentioned. Here, the village people assembled at the temple and made some resolutions. All the village people assembled in front of the temple, as we have seen the picture, that it is a assembly like a people assembly. Having small garbhagraha. The following committees have been formed to rule the village administration. There are committees consisting of 5 members. One is known as annual committee. In Sanskrit, it is known as Samvatsar Varyam, or in Tamil, that is Aandu Varyam. They have to look after entire thing. They are the heading the all other committees. The annual committee is looking after other committees. It is known as Samvatsara Varyam or annual committee. Then garden committee. Garden committee is looking after the garden, because our country is agriculture based. That's why there is a separate ministry known as garden committee in those days. Then tank committee. For irrigation purpose, water is must. So, in order to look after the maintenance of tank, there is a committee known as tank committee, Yeri Varyam in Tamil. Then gold testing committee. in order to get the financial benefits from the agriculture, there is, even the temple received some gold, or the king received some gold. For that purpose, the gold testing committee has nominated. Their main person is to look after the purify of the gold. Then committee for looking and the field, paddy field. Paddy field is here in the village, even till today, the paddy is the main occupation of the agriculture people. For looking after the paddy field, it is known as Kalanivaryam. In Tamil, it is known as Kalanivaryam. It has a separate committee. Then election procedure and qualification. In this inscription, the election procedures and qualifications also are narrated. A representative from central government, namely Tattanur Moovendavelan, conducted the meeting. In present context, there is the election officer in central government or state government. So the king nominated a central government or state government, namely Tattanur Moovendavelan. He came over here and conduct the election system. So the committee consists of 30 members. Each committee had 5 members. So the committee, five committees are there. Each committee is having 5 members. And annual committee members having 12 members. So totally 30 members are there. They have to now elect. So for that purpose, the central government officers came to this village to conduct the election. The election would be conducted through part ticket system. In Tamil, in the inscription, it is mentioned as Koda Olai. It is nothing but ballot box. The qualifications of members are prescribed. First, the qualification is age qualifications. The age, the contester should have the age between 60 to 30 years of age. The 30 years is the minimum age, and 60 years is the maximum age of the contester, the committee member. If he wants to contest the election, he should have 30 years and the above 30 years and below 60 years old. So the age qualifications, what we are seeing now, is also the same thing in this inscription. The second inscription, it is modified. So I have already mentioned in the second year, that is 921 CE, some modifications is occurred. That is, the age also mentioned as 35 to 70. The election procedure and the qualifications again, property qualifications. Nowadays, the property qualifications also nowadays is seeked by the government. The member should have more than quarter value of land with the tax paid in the village on his own. So, this is very important qualifications. He should pay the tax, otherwise he cannot contest the election. He should have some property in the village itself, not other villages. He should be a man of the village. He cannot go away and contest the election in some other village. So, he should have some land within the village boundary. So, he should also pay the tax in his land tax. Property of land is also reduced in the second inscription. This is also reduced in the second inscription. Previously, it was a quarter value of land. Now it is 1/8 of land. If it is there, he can contest the election. It is also remodified in the second inscription. He is having own house. The person who contests the election is having own house in the village, in his own plot, not other plots. So he is having his own plot, own house in the village itself. So he can contest. So this is at present immovable property like that. Educational qualifications, he should be experts. Then education qualification also expressed in this inscription as he should have, this is, since it is a Brahminical village, they mentions the Vedas. He should have some knowledge in Vedas, Sastras, and in executing business, he should have sound working knowledge also. So, he should work to the people. Then he should get good name among the people. Then he got the well through good earning, not bad earning, not any bad earning. So the education qualifications, and he should have clean hand. ஆத்மஸ்வரூபமும் ஆன்மஸ்வரூபமும் பெற்றிருக்க வேண்டும். திஸ் இஸ் த சென்டென்ஸ் வி ஹாவ் இன் த இன்ஸ்கிரிப்ஷன்ஸ். யூ ஷுட் ஹாவ் சவுண்ட் நாலேஜ், சவுண்ட் ஹெல்த், சவுண்ட் மைண்ட். யூ ஷுட் ஹாவ் தட் ஸோ தட் யூ கேன் எலிஜிபிள் டு கண்டெஸ்ட் தி எலெக்ஷன். யூ ஷுட் மென்டலி அண்ட் பிசிக்கலி சவுண்ட் அண்ட் பியூர் பாடி. த பீரியட் ரெஸ்ட்ரிக்ஷன், யூ ஷுட் நாட் டிஸ்சார்ஜ் இஸ் டியூட்டிஸ் ஆஸ் த கமிட்டி மெம்பர் வித்தின் 3 இயர்ஸ். இஸ் பீரியட் இஸ் ஒன்லி 3 இயர்ஸ். ஓ இஃப் ஹி கண்டெஸ்ட் 3 இயர்ஸ், இஃப் ஹி கண்டினியூட் 3 இயர்ஸ், தென் ஈ ஷுட் நாட் அகெயின் கண்டெஸ்ட் தி எலெக்ஷன். திஸ் இஸ் தி சிஸ்டம். ஸோ ஈ ஷுட் லெவ் த பிளேஸ். ஜஸ்ட் பாஸ்ட் அண்ட் ஆர் நாட் த நியர் ரிலேட்டிவ்ஸ் ஈவன் இஸ் ரிலேட்டிவ்ஸ் ஆஃப் சச் கமிட்டி மெம்பர்ஸ் ஆஸ் ஹவ் ரிட்டையர்ட் ஆஃப்டர் டூயிங் கமிட்டி மெம்பர்ஸ். இஸ் ரிலேட்டிவ்ஸ், இஸ் சன்ஸ், இஸ் பிரதர் சன், இஸ் சிஸ்டர் சன், தே ஷுட் நாட் கண்டெஸ்ட் இஃப் ஈ வாஸ் ஆல்ரெடி மெம்பர் ஆஃப் த கமிட்டி. So, he should leave that place. He should produce his wealth property before contesting election. This is very important. When he contests the election, he should produce his wealth before contesting the election. This is very important even in 1000 CE itself. So, the qualification, other qualifications are, he must have possessing qualifications in expertise, knowledge in business. He should have work for the people, as well as possessing good virtues. He should be honest with pure mind. There is a word for bribery also. If he gets any bribery, he should not contest in the election. That is, in Tamil, it is known as kaiyootu. He should not get bribery when he was in the office, when he was elected as a committee member in the previous years. So, they are all prohibited in the election system. Those who were the members for the past 3 years and have not submitted their accounts, they every year they have to submit their accounts, what their assets. This is also very important event in the election system around 1000 CE. So those who were the members for the past 3 years and have not submitted their accounts, they have not contested. And all other relatives also, not only him, his sons, sons of the younger, elder brothers and sisters, children and defaulters, mother, sons of defaulters, paternal aunt and maternal uncle, the uterine brother of defaulters' mother, the uterine brother of defaulters' father, father-in-law, uterine brother of defaulters' wife, the husband of defaulters' sister and her relatives were prohibited to contest election. There is a long list of relatives in this inscription. They were all prohibited if they did some mischiefs in the election, in the as a committee member in the previous. Those who have committed any one of the 5 great sins, you know the 5 great sins, even lying also for one of the sin. If you say lie, he cannot contest. This is the thing in those days. In the lifetime, he cannot contest. This is the condition of that election. Then foolhardy person, then thief, one who has taken forbidden dishes of any kind, who sought the apology for his minister. Even if he did some mischiefs, if he get any apology, even he should not contest the election system. All these disqualified people should not write their name on the part ticket to be put into the part. Those who are eligible, they can exercise their ticket by writing their own name on the part ticket and put it into the part for any of the committee. This is a system we have come across in the inscription. Because nowadays, so people will elect us. But in those days, we ourselves, if the member wanted to become a committee, he should write his own name with the qualifications, with all the qualities if he is having. He writes his name and put it into the pot. This is the system in those days. Then the election procedure. An earthen pot, that is known as kudavolai, tied with a cloth on the mouth portions, tightened on the mouth portions. The pot have been taken from street to street to collect the pot tickets in the village. So, all the streets it runs. So, all the streets they brought to all the streets. And eligible candidate will, if he is willing to contest, he can put, he can write his name and put it into the pot. Then by evening, all the elections, the part again they are taken back to the temple, the mandapa, and those who are having the above qualifications, they have right to write their names and placed inside that pot. Finally, the ballot box, that is a pot which contains written form, form list, have been taken to the public mandapa located at Vaikuntha Perumal temple in the center of the village. Then announcement of the names. Immediately, by the day itself, by the evening itself, they announce the names of the candidates in the villages, those who are elected. In front of the mandapa, all the people of the village assembled in the evening. The eldest among the people, the elder, the central government man who has come from, sent by the king, the village temple priest and the representatives of central government who contested the election assembled and they call a boy who cannot distinguish forms and procedures should be picked the form leaf ticket one by one. He should take the form leaf from the pot and hand it over to the eldest man. It is mentioned in the inscription, the boy should not know whether his father is contested or his mother is, other relatives are contested. There is a word in the Tamil, pagalum iravum ariyadu. He should not know whether it is a night or day. Like that, they have chosen a boy to pick the ticket. This was handed over to a eldest man. The ticket was handed over to a eldest man. Before receiving the form leaf, the eldest man has to show his both hands that he did not possess any leaf with him. So when he takes the form leaf from the boy, the eldest man who is taking the who is receiving the form, he has to raise his hands like this. I am not having anything. I am not having any form leaf before this. So I am taking fresh leaf from the boy. So it should not be misused. So he has shown agalai virithu, kaiyai agalai virithu kaatta vendum. There is a term in inscription, kaiyai agalai virithu kaatta. He should show his hand very, he has raised his hands. So like that he has received the form leaves. He read out the name of the committee. After that, after seeing the form leaves, he read out the name of the committee member, which is already written in the form leaf. And it is handed over to the some other eldest person. He has to attest whether what he has read, the name is correct or not, and checked by another eldest person, and again the eldest persons. It passed on to one by one the eldest persons. So they will announce the name of the candidate selected in the committee. This was again checked by a young man also. Young people also, they will also check, they have the right to check the name of the committee member. In this way, all the members of the committee have been chosen for the election. There are the duty of the members. The duty of the members also prescribed. Totally, 30 members have been elected in this way. They have to work for 3 years. The period of working also, the period of the committee is also prescribed in the inscriptions. It is 3 years. They have to look after the village administration. First, they have to look after the village administration, welfare of the people, maintenance of the tank, irrigation, and looking after the paddy field, and looking after the garden, and testing of gold, receiving as donations. These members were conducted committee, namely annual committee. This committee headed by another committee known as annual committee member. They were Sammacharvaryam. It consists of 12 members. Others are only 5 members. Then removal of the guilty. Suppose if the member committed some mischiefs or committed some nonsense when he is in the office, immediately he will be removed from the membership. If the member is not performed his duty well, or if the member found guilty, he would be removed at any time from the committee. Among the members of the committee, they could select a person as arbitrator. It is referred to in the inscription as Madhyasthan. To convene the meeting, the Madhyastha or arbitrator is the authority to convene the meeting. All the committee members should work 360 days. There is no holidays, there is no leave for them. They have to work to the people for 360 days, all the years. all the days. As pointed out by famous political scientist Larry Diamond, democracy consists of four key elements. They are a political system for choosing and replacing the government through free and fair elections, the active participants of the people as citizens in politics and civic life, then production of the human rights of all citizens, and a rule of law in which the laws and procedures apply equally to all citizens. Uttaramerur inscription records all the above elements in the modern context. It applied to the modern context. What he said, all components are applied to the modern context, which is already narrated in these two inscriptions. It is very important. Our ancestors were the pioneers in the democratic system in the world. So no states in the world having this kind of democratic system and this kind of election system and their qualifications and their working nature and their qualifications, disqualifications, how they conduct the election, how they pick up the elected body, all this we are having around 1000 CE itself. Ever since in the world, this is an unique example of election system in 10th century CE. The democratic kind of election system for the first time recorded in the inscriptions of South India. This kind of election system, we have come across many places in Tamil Nadu, not only in Mitramerur. We have many places, many inscriptions says the Variya Perumakkal, particularly the Manur inscriptions of Maranjadayan from Tirunelveli region, and some of the places in Thondai Mandalam, Tirunindravur, Kavaripakam, Thiruvuvanai, Bagur, very near to Pondicherry. We have the references of election local body, and all the villages also we are having the Urar and Sabha, the local assembly, the people of village, people of assembly, village assembly were there. It is there. So it is very interesting inscriptions we have seen so far. For further information, if you require, you can go to EPG Padasala. Thank you.